rolling if it ain't fire. Won't smoke, won't pass, rolling if it ain't fire. Don't spend no time on a bitch if she ain't fire. That was my second lunch. That's what happens when you try and fit 3,500 calories into actually good, clean, healthy eating food. It's a struggle.
So guys, I was thinking recently just how hard it is to be a YouTuber. You need things like the right equipment. That should never be an excuse, but if you don't have good, you know, vlogging equipment, camera equipment, you're making it a bit hard on yourself. You need the right plot and interesting life, to be honest. But what really intrigues me is your style of video. Now, you'll get certain people who don't really put much thought into it, and their videos go somewhat like this. And I know this because this was me 6-7 months ago. I just came back from the gym. Now I'm gonna have a protein shake. It's really good. I like the protein shake. I'm glad you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you tomorrow. That's their vlog. That used to be my vlog, so it's alright for me to make fun of it because this is me. Now, what I've gone ahead and done is I've just incorporated a bunch of different styles. Now, you notice at the beginning of this video I had cutscenes, which is very Casey Neistat-like. Now, I used to do sort of Casey Neistat videos, even in terms of the soundtracks I would use. And then I just looked at my videos, I'm like, what the hell are you doing? Like, let's try and mix this up. So another person I really look up to is Justin Escalona. And I basically just, his concept of the edits, I took that and applied that to my videos. And, you know, it's really important to find your style. And this is the message I want to leave with you. Decide whether your style will decide whether this message I'm putting across to you is 5 minutes. It can be a long vlog and you can really rant and rave and go on tangents, or whether you want to be punchy and to the point, right? I'm somewhere in the middle. Your style of vlog will decide whether you need something like the camera I have, a Sony A7 Mark II, or just something like I used to have, a Canon G7X flip-up vlog. Decide your style. Try, like, people think, you know, you have to be original, unique. Don't be original, don't be unique. Basically, just use different combinations, right? Take certain things from different aspects. To be honest, I don't even watch fitness videos anymore. I watch videos from different sectors, lifestyle vlogs, you know, spiritual vlogs, like very interesting and intriguing personalities and, you know, a new generation of YouTubers. I look at what they're doing and I think, okay, would this fit well in my vlog? Would it apply well in my vlog? And that's my advice to you guys. Choose your style, mix around, play, and see what cool combinations you can come up with. So guys, do you ever just do a bunch of work and it's mainly computer-based, phone-based, you know, you're really just in front of a screen and you come out of 4 or 5 hours of work and you're just in this weird haze. You're just in this weird haze where, like, where you're struggling to keep your eyes open, they're red and whatnot, but it is 8 o'clock-ish, we're about to go hit a gym session. It's nothing I need more than that right now. We used to roll at the rink, we used to roll at the rink. We'll just place that down. I used to talk way too much, we used to know everything. You couldn't stand me, I couldn't stand you. You said I'm steady playing. Alright guys, so the last chest session I did was on like Saturday, and it was a real heavy hitter. It was with Reed, and we did a lot of functional, heavy, heavy training. Today, I only have an hour, and then the gym closes. I came here super late, had a bunch of work. So I'm doing a workout that I've done quite a few times. Basically, the main idea of it is, number one, you do a warm-up set. Number two, you do your heavy set. Number three, you do a drop set. And with all three of these sets, you do contractions, up, middle, and down. And it's meant to shape your chest. Whenever I've done this workout, it's been killer. So I'm just gonna leave you guys with some of the workouts, some of the highlights, so you can see what it's like. Alright guys, super, changing the aperture.
Being honest, I haven't been reading for like the past 4 days.
You're on camera.
That's fine, I'm used to it now.
Okay, go for it.
Yeah, so to be honest, I'm going to be honest with myself, so you guys should be as well. I haven't been reading for the past 4 to 5 days, and that's because I think I don't have enough time. But that's just an excuse, so today I started again and I'm hitting it again hard. So make sure to read your books.
There we go. Alright guys, so hit a really good workout. I'm sure you've seen Lewis a couple times. He goes to my gym. You know, we've been doing a lot of work together. You know, brainstorming together. He is genuinely, like, you know, I mean this in such a respectful way. Like, he's who I was maybe like 6 months ago, but he's going way quicker than I ever would. Like, the progress he's made in the last 6 months. He's been doing a cut, which he's been running by himself. It's been crazy, crazy. Wait, show him your hair.
Oh, wait, let me get a mirror.
Alright guys, like, he got a new haircut recently. It looks super, super fresh. Just like a bunch of cool changes happening in his life. And to be honest, that's what happens when you associate yourself with like-minded individuals. This sounds like such a lecture, but yeah guys, super good workout. Really felt really, really carb loaded, so I had a pretty good pump. Let's go. So guys, after discussing it in either last vlog or the vlog before that, I got quite a few questions on the whole meal prep thing. So I have my scale, I have my sweet potatoes, good glycemic index, I have my eggs. I'm not gonna lie, my mom prepared this for me because she's just an angel and she understands I'm really busy, so my mom's definitely watching this, so thank you mom, love you. Basically what I do is I have two tubs, so I split up into a first lunch and then a second lunch. As I said, it's hard to get the calories in, but when you start eating healthy, when you start getting good herbs in your body, good spices in your body, good nutrients in your body, focusing more on micronutrients than macronutrients, you just feel amazing. And I'll actually show you something that I'm starting to do right after this. So guys, this was what I was talking about. I'm not even gonna try to pronounce it, but if that stays in focus, it stems from, I think, like a ginger plant or something. I mean, it's been used for thousands of years. Helps with sleep. I used to use ZMA, and I'm gonna start using that again, but this is definitely something interesting to, you know, try. I've been really looking into spices, herbs, and as I said, looking into micronutrients and turning someone, I guess, to the Western world, and trying to see what sort of solutions and remedies they have just to keep me on top of my game. So before bed, milk, honey, this powder. Honestly guys, it is really, really disgusting, but you gotta do what you gotta do. So guys, this day is coming to a close. It is currently 1:45 in the morning. I'm about to go to sleep, made my tea, just about to meditate, listen to some affirmations, and then head off to bed. Night is sort of my time, to be honest. It's really the dark recesses of the night where I excel and I flourish and I get super, super excited and I put in the work. Yeah, this is really my time, and honestly, at night, I can't really work downstairs, so this is where I make moves.
Just another kid that's going through life so worried that I won't be accepted, but I could do anything. You said that and you meant that. You took me places, you spent that. They said no, we went back. Checks bounced, but we bounced back. I put all the money in your accounts back, and I thank you. I don't know, I would really be without that. It worked out, man, you deserve it.
Alright guys, so I do not know what was in that powder. I mean, I do know what's in the powder, but I will do some more research. But seriously, check this out, guys. We got 4 hours and 45 minutes of sleep, but our deep sleep was 3 hours and 9 minutes of that. Our light sleep was only 1 hour and 35 minutes, fell asleep in 11, and I only woke up one time, apparently, around 5:35, but, jeez, I woke up, like, I think I woke up at around 6:43, with this, like, early alarm feature. It said I was in light sleep, so it just decided to wake me up, like, 20 minutes early, and I feel great. Very, very happy with that. So guys, I thought I would just take this time to say a huge, huge thank you. Now, you hear all these big YouTubers talking about how in their first year they had maybe 100 subscribers, 200, 300, 400 subscribers. You know, within their second, third year, like after their third year, they got to 5,000, 10,000 subscribers. And, you know, I'm at 1,200 and it's been around 7 months and I grow around 200, 250 each month. I don't give a shit. I seriously do not care at all. And guys, I do social media consultation, if you didn't know that. And whenever I'm working with someone who's trying to build a personal brand, I tell them, please just stop looking at the damn analytics. Stop looking at the numbers and start looking at what are people saying to you? How are people responding to you? How are people opening up to you? And guys, the sort of messages I get through Snapchat, through Instagram, even through the comments on YouTube, it's insane. Seriously, some of you guys are so incredible. Some of you guys are working so hard to achieve your dreams. And the fact that you're coming to me, you know, the amount of humility you guys have. So you guys coming to me for advice, for help, is incredible. All I care about is the quality of interactions. I remember around four months ago, I made a commitment. I looked at my Instagram, I looked at my social media, and I thought, okay, I have, you know, I'm growing in numbers, but who's really there? And since then, I've decided to care more than anything. And wow, the response has been incredible. I'm getting, you know, even things like having all my friends watching all these vlogs, like all these vlogs, like it means the world to me. If you're one of my friends, seriously, thank you for watching these things. I know you're super busy. I know IB kills. The fact that people who I don't know are sending me huge paragraphs about how I've inspired, motivated them. I've had a couple people tell me that I'm the reason they've started YouTube. How crazy is that? So I want to end off this video by saying a huge, huge thank you. And I want to make a commitment that I'm going to keep going and I'm going to try and help as many people as I can. I'm going to keep trying things myself, keep experimenting, see what works, see what doesn't. I'm going to share it with you guys. So if you've enjoyed this video, please leave a like. I'll see you in the next one. Let's cue the outro in 3, 2, 1.